Evening, folks. This is Best in Slot. We are back building our campaign zoo in Planet Zoo. We are on Maple Leaf Park. Remember, we're building our own completely unique zoo in this Taiga kind of environment. In the last video, we added our three lovely little bison over here. Over here, we have some tortoises and some peafowl going a little bit mental, but that's okay. I'm down with that. Today, we're going to do something pretty cool. I'm in a gorilla kind of mood. I mean, who isn't in a gorilla kind of mood, right? So, let's have a little look. I think I did pick a gorilla up, right? Yes, I'm thinking gorilla slash lemur will be a pretty interesting exhibit build. So that's what we're going to do. Let's give that a go. La 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 la. Wait, what type of lemur is it? I'm already confused. Ring-tailed. No, not red-dwarfed. Ring-tailed, there we go. What have we got here? We have terrible, terrible lemurs. That's what we have. That's okay. If we just pick up these, that should be enough. I wouldn't mind another gorilla, but I'm not convinced we're going to be able to afford one. If we can get a female, that'd be great. Let's give it a go. What's going on here? Oh, I can't afford it. I've never seen that before. I've always been able to afford everything. Right, what are we looking for? Western lowland gorilla. Yeah, that's not happening. That's not happening at all. So what we actually need to hope for is babies. What should I... Oh, it is a very exposed exhibit, isn't it? I kind of feel bad for them. Let's see if we can get some enrichment in here, make them feel a little bit better. Shut up. Bloody peacocks. Peafowls, peacock just... They're always fine. The social distress goes up when they're near the gate, but then they kind of chill after a little bit. Let's get these ticket prices up a little bit. My most appealing animal is the animal not in my zoo. That's a good sign right there. Vet research. I don't know why. Why do I have so many vets? I have no idea, but let's just... Hey, there we go. Look at that, look at that, look at that. American bison. Oh, they're both. Oh, he's a stud. Frickin' Tyson's just going around impregnating everybody. The dream. Right, so I think we're going to build it up here. So you're going to walk along this path. You're going to curl around there. We'll have a little staff area probably at the bottom. Yeah. And then we'll do like a Western Lowland Gorilla slash Lemur exhibit. Is that going to be too small? I could include this bit. Is that going to work? Give them a little bit of a mountain. Have like a climbing frame that goes up there. That might be pretty cool. I need it to be decent size. It's a gorilla, right? Gorillas are the big boys. Or is it a big girl? I can't remember. It's a big something anyway. What about over here? Oh, that's a nice... I kind of like that for the wolves, though, so... Yeah, okay. Let's give this a go. I'm not totally convinced this is going to work, but... You never know unless you try, folks. If you believe it will happen, it will happen. I've got to stop quoting, of all people, Jeremy Bloody Clarkson. Okay. I think we're probably going to make this wood just because it kind of suits what we're doing here. Right. So we need to make sure there's room for a staff area, which there already isn't, and B... God, right, it's going to be messy. Might have to bring that in. Because you don't want the staff area to clip the path because it annoys people. Yeah, we'll see what we can do. Let's go up. If I start here and then drag it down, is that going to work? It's quite frankly beautiful, I think you'll all agree. The good thing about the babies, though, is hopefully what that means is we'll be able to sell some of them for CC and maybe get a breeding pair off gorillas, which would obviously be awesome. It's going to be a... This is fine, we can organise this in a second. There we go, that is... I think we can all admit that is just gorgeous, really. Love me a little corridor, it's my new fetish. Right, there we go. Let's see if that makes anyone happy. Samira, a lovely little Indian peafowl. Absolutely adorable. It's about to pop out some bebbers. Those noises you hear are baby noises. They will actually pop out the kids if you stare at them. As weird as that sounds. She's sitting down. She's popping them out. There they are. Only one. Come on, love. I need more bebbers. Oh, two. There they are. They're hiding inside each other, just as most children should do. Hopefully we can get some enrichment for those at some point. I should expect... I mean, I'm surprised they're breeding, considering the zero enrichment, but that will help them out a little bit. Just to confirm, by the way, I know these aren't turtles, but they happen to live in a nice, wet place, okay? Give them a break. I'm tired of you people judging my tortoises. They want to live in the middle of a bloody lake, let them live in the middle of a bloody lake, alright? Oh, he's going up. He's going up. There we go. Got ourselves a gorilla, Rudo. The Western Elf. He's an absolute beast. I love him. He's such a good... Ah. He's not going to be happy until we get him a friend. I hate to break it to you, Rudo, but I don't think that's going to happen, buddy. I will keep an eye out, but the chances seem rather low of you getting a pal anytime soon. Terrain. Yep, yeah, plenty of that. Obviously, we're going to have some climbing room in there. Now, can Rudo escape? Let's find out. Habitat. No. Sweet. Now, he might be able to when he gets up there. We'll see. But at the moment, he's contained. The idea is to... I can't see a bloody thing. Is hopefully for the climbing area to take you up onto this higher tier. So we can't put anything up there food-wise because the keepers are never going to get up there. But we could put, like, enrichment items up there. And that gives them a cool incentive to climb up there. Maybe we'll put the shelter up there as well. Have, like, a big hut sitting over the top. This is a good start. I'm optimistic. Let's get our lemurs in. Well, what's going on? We need some lights. I think we can safely say. I can't see a blimmin' thing. There's also a baby bison on the way, which is super exciting. If you're into baby bison. And who isn't, quite frankly? Oh my god, the peafowl though. That's the most obnoxious noise in the world, I swear. Shut up. I feel mean, but they are very annoying. Oh my god, please stop. That is agonizing, it really is. What's going on? Oh, sweet, there we go.
Wow. Looks like we already have a zoo, don't we? That was fast. You're doing me proud, you know. I'll be honest. When I first pictured entrusting someone else to build a zoo, I always imagined it'd be my child doing it. I guess it wasn't to be, huh? Unless... I don't suppose you're open to being adopted, are you? Oh, almost forgot. Now you've completed your first lot of jobs, or... bronze objectives, as Nancy likes to say. You can, if you wish, move on to the next zoo. Obviously, I'd prefer that you stayed on here and took care of the rest of those objectives. But I can certainly understand the desire to keep moving onwards and upwards, just like an escalator. Or a downwards escalator, which is going the wrong way.
Not a happy bunny right now. I was hoping to maybe get some bonus CC for the mission. Obviously, that didn't happen. Right, so. Still nothing for the tortoise. Weston, you are my priority right now, buddy. I can do this. I actually did not know this was a thing. Somebody told me about this in the last video. I said, I assume you know about this. I actually didn't, so thank you, random YouTube person. I kind of want to move this back. It's about there. I didn't realize we had so much room here. Let's move all this. Oh no, it's wet. Get you nice and dry, love. This is taking a little longer than I anticipated. That's okay, that's okay. I would like to get maybe the exhibit animals done today as well. That would be pretty cool. I also need to do some design work though. Everything's very mundane right now. But I'm excited about this. Okay, so we've got a little water up there as well, which is cool. Because they have none down here and they are literally not gonna get any. Right, let's build a thing. What's the biggest platform I've got? That 4x4, okay. I'm gonna stick that there. This is their goal, to get up here. I'm quite excited about this. This is not something I've really done. I haven't really spent much time with just climbing stuff in general. I kind of neglected it. That. Just gonna make this look as realistic. Basically, I'd like it to observe very basic physics. That would be nice. You know, it has to. Like, the log is not gonna. It's not gonna float. For example, that's really all I'm looking for. I don't want a floater. It's very basics. What we need here to make this look okay. Okay, that actually took a surprisingly long time. The very basics are done. It is, as you can tell, a masterpiece of moderate boredom. Now let's have a little look and see if our little gorilla, our huge gorilla, can get up. Oh. No, right. There's a slight problem here, apparently. We can fix that. Slight problems are my specialty. I don't know why that's a slight problem, but I think I probably just need to... Wait, seriously? That seems unlikely to me, but okay, no, we can deal. We're going to just tilt that a little bit that way, and then we can bring it down. Okay, there we go. Sorted. Bet it's fixed. Bet it's 100% totally working right now. Question mark. Update. Nice! There we go! You can get all the way to the top. That's very cool. Now, just need to test the same with the lemurs. Yes, because I figured the lemurs can probably get out. Although, why they can get out there, I'm not actually sure. We're going to just push the terrain... Okay, I can't push the terrain down. How come they can get out of there? It's double... Huh. Alright. Huh. Let me think about that. No, I've got nothing. Okay, cool. So, let's find some rocks, and we'll cover it in rocks, and that will solve the problem. Rocks solve every single problem. It's science. You can't argue with science. You can't. People try all the time to argue with science. They always say you can't argue with science, but you absolutely can argue with science. Whether you should argue with science is another kettle of fish. Let's get rocky. I wanted a rocky area there anyway, right? Just for aesthetics, you see? Look at that, it's beautiful. Okay, lemur, talk to me. Where are you? You're tiny, that's where you are. Eh? Eh? Nice, there we go. Does that now count as hard shelter as well? I'm hopeful. Yes, sweet. Okay, and thankfully they should both be African tropical, right? So we can just kind of lead in with that. We've got some crossover that I'd like to get rid of. Probably, I can't get rid of that one either. Those are my favorite of the plants. Yes, cough. Big cough. So, continent. This is not really going to fit in the park already, but that's fine. Africa tropical. What can we play around with? We need some big old trees, but controlled big old trees. What's the biggest? Kapok. Ah, oh, I love me a kapok. Do have to be a little careful with the kapok. Is he going to get out with that? Well, you know what? We'll just stick it in and we'll hope for the best. That's my motto. Stick another one there. Got some custard apples, which are amazing. They make great bushes, the custard apple. Look at that. Beautiful. Some people say this doesn't look realistic. That to me just looks like a bush. So, I will not hear anything against my beloved custard apple trees. You hear me? Not a gosh darn thing. We're getting there. We're getting there. For some reason, it seems to have gone down. Oh, he's gone up. Look, he climbed. He climbed up the whole thing. That's really cool. Hey, buddy. Hello. I know, you need a friend. I really wish I could give you one. Unfortunately, I kind of spent all my money on you. So really, it's your own fault. If you were just cheap, then we wouldn't have this issue, would we? I'm hoping we can maybe sell some babies. Lettuce, I don't know the peppers. Oh, he's giving it a nudge. Look at him go. Oh, she. He's giving it a nudge. It's Burhan. Burhan's showing those balls who's boss. Are we making profit? We seem to be making profit. Meow, meow. What I might do is actually put the exhibits up here. All of them, basically. It's a popular little area. We've got staff nearby. It's lit up. Yeah, I think that's what we'll end up doing. Right, I want to get this gorilla a little bit happier, if possible. Also, want to check the lemurs, actually, before we do anything else. We have just added a bunch of plants. We have three little peafowls as well. I would like to make sure that the lemurs can't escape. That should really be the first thing we check. First thing. Lemur. Come here. Lemur? I barely know her. Lol. How are we doing? Okay, yeah. Surprisingly good is how we're doing. Right then. Lemur gorilla habitat. I really like that. Just like on a fundamental level, I think that's a cool idea for a habitat. They should be able to share the same feeder as well. I'm just going to give them a little bit more. Where's my gorilla? I think this doesn't count as climbing. Just because of the... it's always, you know... What if I put poles in? Let me just see if that works. Right, let's get a big old pole. The biggest pole we can find. There we go. Climbable log, 6 meters. Beauty. I think this will count and boost the gorilla's climbing higher. So I'm going to put these in. Nice and quick smart like that. Let's see if that did anything. How are we doing? Okay, so on 17.7, keep that number in mind. I'll put some over here as well. It's a little bit bendy. Just a little bit, but that's fine. That's science. Let's pretend that's science. There we go. Just testing you folks, testing you. Testing you, testing my gorillas. Only the premiest gorillas, which is creamiest and premium together in one word. It's disgusting. Nope, still 17.7, okay. Wait, right? Oh, wait, that should recalculate though. Hey, look at that, Gorilla Deborah! Okay, so, like I said, I think we're gonna put the exhibit animals just here, right? I'm not that excited about the exhibit animals, but it's something to make this long walk a little bit more interesting. So we need, I think 5 at the end, 6. Maybe we'll put 3 here, we'll put 3 somewhere else. Yeah, let's do that. Let's grab those now. My god. Let me just sit them on this little cliff edge here. That's pretty cool, actually. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, ba-dum, bum, bum, bum. There we go. Look at that. Love that water dripping effect. Beautiful stuff. Exhibit trading. What do we want? Well, we are going to go for high genetic appeal. I want breeding pairs, though, so... What can we get for cash? We can get... We can get Throg. Throg shall return. Okay, so we've got a breeding pair of Goliaths. That is the only one currently available. I don't want to spend any CC on these, so let's go back to bronze instead. Let's get a green iguana. That's awesome. I'm very excited about that. And... What am I feeling? Feeling a snail. That's what I'm feeling. Feeling a snail. Love me a snail. Right. We've got breeding pairs of all of those. Let's get these moved in. And they're all foresty feeling, which is nice. We might do like a little desert section as well. So this is the forest bit, and then we'll have a desert bit as well, which I think is cool. Okay, but they are not happy. As you can see, this has all popped up. I'm super annoyed at me. What we need to do is layout, which means research climate, though. Climate sucks. Let's get that right up. Let's get that humidity up as well. How are we doing? It's so incredibly slow. Okay, let's move on to the next one whilst we wait. We need to get that temperature up a bit, quite a bit as well, and humidity down a little bit. And then over here, what do we need? More temperature, a little bit less humidity. Let's see how we're doing. It's going to be tight, a little bit more. There we go, happy iguana-ish. Happy snails-ish. And happy frog-ish. I need to name one of these frog. Hopefully one of them already is randomly. No, it's Faraji. That's a great name, Faraji. But Throg has returned. He's using Faraji as a vessel for himself, you see. If you don't know who Throg is, you should go watch my beta playthrough, by the way. He is the Goliath Throg. It was this crazy Goliath Frog I had, called Throg, as it happens, in my franchise mode playthrough in the beta. And he had... His net worth, his like value to the park was like 10,000, which was more than elephants, it was more than giraffes, it was more than lions. It was insane. The dude was just a baller, a little frog. He really was. And then he died, and we were all very sad. Sad forever. Come on. I suspect this is my fault for not having angle snap on correctly. What's this? Right, that's the frog. I think this is the snail. Right? Yeesh. That would make this the iguana. Cool. I'm quite excited about the iguana. Where is he? There they are. Look at that. That's actually really cool. Hey, buddy. Peafowl. How happy are my peafowl? I mean, if you listen to them, you'd assume terribly, terribly unhappy because they just make crazy noises. I would love some food enrichment for... Oh, hello. I was about to say, for the Western Lowland Gorilla, so hopefully we've just got a little bit of luck there. Let's have a look. Oh, I don't want to speed up time this much. I don't think there's actually any point in speeding up time on this campaign playthrough. We need to chill, you know? I'm going to take a chill. What did we get? Yes, we got a forage box. Sweet. He's eating! He's numbing away! He's a big boy! I do want to get you a friend, but 79%, considering what we've gone through, is not bad. You know, enrichment just jumped up a lot. He needs more toys. I don't really know what to do about that. Do you have a sprinkler? I think so. Yeah, they're 4%. Nothing. 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 Well, let's just have to research some more. That's fine. What's he up to? He looks very cool in the snow. He doesn't really suit it. He looks bizarre, actually. But in a nice way. In a cool way, you know? Oh, he's a walking. He's on the beat. Look at that. The beast. Doing gorilla things. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Little Lima must be freaking terrified. He's on the move. He's a proper silverback, isn't he? He's a big silver boy. Sweet. Okay. Let's have a look at our challenge. So, we need 10 more habitat species. I need to get at least one more in this video. I'm not happy unless I get at least that. Then we can add 2 more exhibit species. That's dead easy. I don't know what a yearly profit is, but that's something we can work on pretty easily as well. So, I need one more species. I want to do wolf. I want to do wolves here. I think this is a really cool place for a wolf. I don't know why this speaks to me in wolf. I speak wolf, by the way, in case you're curious. But I think that's what we're going to go with. So, again, we're not doing anything complex here. We're just going to keep it chill. I think I want to include barrier around there. Around there. This will be the viewing area on the left. And we can put the staff area here on the left. Cool. Let's get to work. Curvy. You've got to make it sexy, folks. You've got to make it sexy. Now, on the plus side, these wolves should be pretty happy with this environment by default, right? Because it's a Taiga North American environment. Taiga. Taiga. Is it Taiga? I keep forgetting. Somebody shouts at me about it in the comments. It's fine. Let's bring that across. Where are we going? Oh, that's a little bit longer than I intended, actually. Although, do I really want to block off the water? Yeah, I actually kind of like that idea for some reason. I'm feeling funky. There's a little noise that just happened. I think it's because about to have offspring. But to me, it sounds remarkably like my ringtone. So I keep thinking that I'm hearing my ringtone. And I'm like, no, phone, shut up, I'm recording for YouTube. Be quiet, please. It's never the case. Nobody ever rings me. Okay, let's get rid of these fences here. We have to do the same thing again. We're just going to put in... that's a good viewing area, though. Ah, no, it's fine. Screw it. Put that in there. And then we connect it back up again. You can see how it drops down with that weird little shape into the ground. That kind of like, pew, diamond downwards. Diamond downwards. That's going to be my new band name. Ah, we need a habitat gate. I'm going to sit with the wood. Boop. Grab all this. This should be good, right? I can't imagine this would be a problem. Huh. Oh, is it because it's not watertight? Are you the problem child? You're fine. You the problem child. Okay. One of you's the problem child. I don't know who. None of you. Which one of you is squaring up to me? Okay. Curious. Okay. Maybe it's just one of the ones in the mountain. I love that. Right on the tip of the mountain as well. That's really cool. There we go. Okay. Yeah, whatever. It's fine. The wolves in this game are actually super annoying. So, they've got a mechanic where they fight to be, like, the alpha. But this doesn't make sense to me. But I've seen people complaining about this. I do want to bring it up. If we nip down to our timber wolf, I believe it's social, unless I'm crazy, is like... Yeah, 2. Why is it 2? Wolves are very social animals that live in family packs. 2! I don't understand. I mean, it says young adult offspring. That's why, but... I don't know, you can't have an alpha wolf if you've only got 2 wolves. You've got an alpha male and an alpha female, and then no other adult wolves. That doesn't make sense to me. Hey ho, what are you going to do? Facilities! Let's get a keeper hut. We always need a keeper hut. Let's get a staff room. Let's get a thing. That's a thing. Let's get it. Animal has escaped. Any bets on who that is? I'm betting... The hell was that? Oh. What? My peafowl? How did you... Oh, the barrier broke. Right. Oh god, they're all on a move. Mechanic, oh no! All the peafowl are doing a runner. I'm just going to go ahead and hire another mechanic, just in case. The great peafowl escape. Oh my god, look at them go. All just legging it. You're working on the barrier for me, buddy. Yeah, okay. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's only a peafowl. People don't care about the peafowl. I just love all. It's all the kids as well. All the baby peafowl have just gone on a little mission out into the wilderness. That's very cool. Oh, that's broken as well. Everything's broken. You're broken as well. Did I not call a mechanic a few ages ago? Yeah, that was... Okay, let's get another mechanic. I can't be mad about that. I just think that's cool. There we go. Beautiful. Plant coverage. We're obviously going to make that look a lot nicer. We need to get some research going on about 10 trillion different animals. All my exotic animals are dying, which is nice. But, right, that's... been a success, I think. We're up to 6 habitat animals, we're up to 3 out of 6. So we need 4 more habitat animals. And we need 2 more, we need 4 more habitat animals, 3 more exhibit animals. And we'll do those in the next video, because this has already gone on far too long and I've got to cut the hell out of it. So what are we going to get? We're going to get saltwater crocodile. And then I'd like 2 things that can live together. But I'd also like a bear. Nyala. Nyala and Sable, can we pull that off? Oh, I also want Snow Leopard, but we can't seem to get Snow Leopard. We could maybe put the macaques in with the lemurs and the... Should we try that? Maybe the macaques can live with the lemurs and the gorillas and we'll have this huge, awesome primate kind of exhibit. We might do that. And then we only need 3 more. So there'll be those, it'll be the crocodiles, it'll be the... Formus and Black Bear, probably. And then something else. We'll think about that. Maybe the Nyala. I quite like the Nyalas. Okay, cool. We'll do that in the next video. I'm probably going to spend a little time here just cleaning things up, you know, putting some decoration in, like, on just some very basic stuff. Just covering the building so they look a little less boring. Okay, I went back and I chucked in loads of plants and I kind of redid a bit of the park, decorated it up a little bit. It didn't take that long just shoving plants in more than anything else. Not even shoved the rocks in quite yet. Somebody's making lots of noise outside. Anyways, so I thought I'd do a quick little tour at the end of the video. No new animals or anything like that. Of course, we're saving that for the next episode. So, the staff buildings now have, you know, tiling and such. No roofs yet, but they will. Loads of plant life and stuff, so it's a much nicer opening as you walk through. We've got a nicely little lit up staff area, a little shop area here with a little metal corridor down to the toilets. They've got roofs. It really is just a billion plants everywhere. A billion plants and a billion lights. So as you walk along, you see, I think everything just looks a lot nicer. Just chucking plants in makes an absolute huge world of difference. It really does. If you cross over here, same kind of deal. Put some plants in our exhibit over there. Put some plants all around this little staff area down here. Same thing. Let's go left first. Up the hill. Lampposts all the way up. Lots and lots of plants, because plants are the best. Surrounded this with plants. I think we're going to leave these uncovered for now. I'm not totally sure. We don't really have access to many building materials, no wooden building materials. So I'm going to keep those like that for now. Keep the plants around there. And same thing, put a little building around there. Lots of plants, lots of plants, lots of plants, lots of lights. Can I bring that up? This area is obviously not done because we've not done anything over there quite yet. But you can see from above, it already looks about 5,000 times nicer. It looks more like a Taiga forest. I know it looks like a forest, and everything I build looks like a forest, but it's pretty, and that's all that matters. And also, I really like how these lights look by the water. So you've got this much more open area over here. You can walk by, it's all lit up, and you turn to the left. Again, definitely more open. There's some plant life there, there's some rocks and some flowers, and then obviously I need to do some work up here where the wolves are, but I have gone ahead and put lights absolutely bloody everywhere. Just light the whole thing up. Get it shiny. So, that is our Maple Leaf Park. In the next video, we'll be finishing it off. We'll be adding 4 more species. The wolf. No, we already did that. The crocodile. The Nyala. The Formosan Black Bear. And whatever the hell the other one was. Yeah? Yeah. Whatever the hell the other one was. And then we'll be chucking in a few more exhibit animals as well. So... yeah, looks a lot nicer, I think. Hopefully we can keep up this kind of style in the next video, and we should end up with a pretty cool-looking park. Until then, thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.